I'm Monica Pearson with This Week in Black History. It was 59 years ago today that a group of activists boarded segregated buses in Washington, D.C. in the first of nearly 50 demonstrations known as the Freedom Rides. The rides were a response to the government's failure to enforce the anti-segregation rulings of the U.S. Supreme Court, making segregated interstate buses unconstitutional. The Congress of Racial Equality, or CORE, planned the demonstrations and were led by their director, James Farmer. A group of 13 riders, 7 black and 6 white, boarded 2 buses in Washington, traveling through 6 southern states before arriving in New Orleans. On each bus, at least one interracial pair would sit together. One black rider would sit in the front and one would sit in the back in order to avoid arrest and arrange bail for the rest once they reached the South. Among the first riders was 21-year-old John Lewis, who was physically attacked in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Several others were arrested along the way. Things got worse in Alabama. Police conspired with the Ku Klux Klan to assault the riders when they stopped in Anniston. One bus was firebombed by the KKK on May 14th, and Klan members boarded the other bus and attacked the protesters. Many of the demonstrators were injured, and when taken to Alabama hospitals, were denied care. That called national attention to the movement. The administration of President John F. Kennedy pressured the state to allow the riders to continue, and members of the National Student Movement and SNCC stepped in for the original riders to continue the journey. Riders were met with mob violence again in Montgomery. They were beaten with pipes and baseball bats. On May 21st, the riders met with over 1,500 worshipers at the church of Reverend Ralph David Abernathy, the First Baptist Church. But once again, they were attacked, this time by 3,000 white segregationists. They hit the church with bricks and tear gas until the government called in the National Guard to break up the mob. The riders arrived in Jackson, Mississippi, May 24th, where they were arrested en masse and subjected to abusive treatment in the state penitentiary. Although this first ride never made it to its original destination, New Orleans, the dozen of rides that followed it eventually led to the desegregation of buses nationwide and inspired millions to join the civil rights movement as it grew throughout the 60s.